Okay, our next step now, I'm going to change the contact breakers. You see they're fairly well burned out. So I'm going to replace them with a new set. And we'll install these, that's our next step. Okay, to remove these, hold points. Pair of pliers and loosen the little screw there. Off the plastic washer there. Off the wire. Undo the screw, adjust the screw here, and be careful not to lose the washer, so lift them off gently. There you have it. Next step, we'll replace these contacts and set the new ones up, and that's our next step. Now I'm going to install the new set here and just pop them in like that. A little screw here, like that. Make sure you don't lose the washer. Push them down. And just set the gap there about 16. So I can do this by eye, I've done it many times, so don't have to use the gauges. So we haven't got a set of gauges, you just use a piece of matchbox paper. So it's about 16 mil, set the points. So if you've got feeler gauges, put the feeler gauges to the gap there. You see the gap there. So next step, we're going to put the wire back on and tighten up the screw. I'll give you a better view of the gap there in a minute. That's the wire tightened up. Now you can see the gap in the points there. About 16 mil. Make sure the high points of the contacts are on the nice part of the lobe here. You've got four high parts. Make sure you're on the cranker and the engine. The other there. And then you have the gap. You can just loosen the screw here. Adjust the gap up and down. So that's the gap set now. And next step, we'll put her on the rotor arm. And we'll fire it up. Now we'll crank over the engine. You have a nice new blue spark. There you have it. Next step on the rotor arm now, and we'll switch off the ignition here, and then we'll fire up the engine. Now, before we put the rotor on, a wee bit of grease here on the screwdriver. A wee drop of grease on the hole there. A wee crap on here. That'll keep the points in from closing, from wearing at this part here, and the points. So your contact breakers last a bit longer. A wee bit on the lobe there. A wee bit on here. And you put on the rotor and then make sure the little notch is on the slot there. Push it all the way home. Next step upon the subwoofer cap, and then we'll fire it up. Okay, recheck the cap again there. Check the gap. Gap's good. Check the spark. Good spark. Now we'll put the cap back on. On the clips each side. Hold the cap down while you put the clips on. Switch on the ignition. Contact breakers placed on our Ferguson T20.